Hello, my name is Seung Jun Lee, and I come from Pohang University of Science and Technology, which is in South Korea. And I'm talking about maximum area rectangles in a simple polygon. First, about this problem, in computational geometry, finding a largest figure of certain prescribed shape contained in a container is very fundamental and important problem. So there are many studies about finding largest basic shapes such as triangle, rectangle, or other shape contained in convex polygon or simple polygon. Here, convex polygon means a polygon which consists of convex vertices, and convex vertices means a vertex which has internal angle is less than pi. And of course, there is a vertex which has internal vertices bigger than pi. We call it reflex vertex. And yeah, here is the example of convex polygon and finding the largest triangle in this convex polygon. And here is example of finding the largest rectangle in convex polygon. And our problem is finding the largest rectangle in simple polygon. And simple polygon means polygon without intersection of edges. Here, left figure is polygon, but there is intersection, so it is not simple. But right polygon has no intersection of edges, so it is simple polygon. And our goal is finding this kind of rectangle in this simple polygon. There are many previous results, and first, we can distinguish rectangle as axis parallel rectangles and arbitrary orientation rectangles. In the case of axis parallel rectangles, it can be found largest axis parallel rectangles in log n time if the container is convex polygon, with assuming the convex polygon is already stored in the memory. And in the case of simple polygon, we can find largest area axis parallel rectangle in n log n time using divide and conquer algorithm. And if there is a hole in the simple polygon, we can find largest rectangle in n log square time using linear space. And also, there is study about arbitrary orientation rectangle. And in the convex polygon, we can find the largest rectangle arbitrary orientation in n cubic time using linear space. And there is no result about arbitrary orientation rectangle in simple polygons. And this is our result. We give an algorithm that compute the largest area arbitrary orientation rectangle in n cubic log n time using kn square space. Here, k is the number of reflex vertices in the polygon.
What do you mean by reflex vertex?
Reflex vertex means non-convex vertex, and convex vertex means inner degree is less than pi. Okay. And to do this, we classified largest rectangles into six types. And first, there is a recalled contact, the intersection of rectangle and polygon boundary. And there are two types of contacts. First one is corner contact, which is the intersection of polygon and rectangle. There is a intersection on the corner of rectangle. And if the intersection lies on the side of rectangle, we call it side contact. And here is a six-phase classification. And note that type A and type F has no side contact, and other type has or contains side contacts. And we have to know some concepts. First, a rectangle, we call rectangle is local maximum rectangle, shortly LMR, if the area function among rectangles inscribed in P gives local maximum. We can regard a rectangle as a point in six-dimensional space. And so the area function is from this six-dimensional space to real domain. And so we can consider this kind of rectangle. And also, we called a set of contacts Z is a determining set of contacts, shortly DS, if the largest rectangle satisfying Z has finite area and the largest rectangle satisfying any proper subset of Z has greater or infinite area. Intuitively, this means the minimal set of contacts that can determine the largest rectangle. And next, imagine there is a rectangle R that satisfies DSG. Here, satisfy means a rectangle R have contacts that elements of Z. If all elements of Z appears on the context of R, then we say a rectangle satisfies a DSG. And for this kind of rectangle, if a rectangle have another context other than Z, then we call it a breaking configuration of Z. And if this rectangle is LMR, but no other context that other than Z, then we call it maximal configuration. So from this definition, we can get following lemma. On LMR, satisfying Z is one of maximal configuration or breaking configuration. So let's start from type A. Type A is most simple case because type A is two opposite corner contacts on the convex vertex of P, and there is lemma, every LMR of type A is square because the diagonal is fixed. So there is fixed diagonal, then the only of course, the largest rectangle is square. So using this fact, we found all LMR of type A by constructing the ray shifting data structure, which can be constructed in linear time and space by Hostberger and Shuri's one, if we use, and which support a ray shifting query in log n time. Here, ray shifting is given a ray from some point to a direction, find the first intersection of this ray and boundary of polygon. This is ray shifting query. And so we construct this data structure, and then for every pair of convex vertices of P, we only consider visible pair, and visible means V prime, the lines, the segment V prime, totally lies in polygon P. So we call it visible. And for this kind of all pairs, we determine the square with diagonal V prime is contained in P by using above ray shifting data structure.
If the what is supported in the diagonal is not a square but a rectangle, then you're saying it violates local maximality.
Yes.
So I didn't quite get why it violates. Maybe the definition of locally maximum was not very clear.
Because if it is not a square, then we can rotate and we can get the bigger area. The formal proof is in our paper.
the definition of locally maximum, what is it?
Definition of locally maximal. Locally maximal is for not all rectangle, for a rectangle lies in polygon, then we restrict rectangles, right? Okay. Then for this restriction, there is locally maximal points in.
You fix the contact points.
No. I don't have to fix. Just for every possible rectangles. Yeah. And using this, we can find the LMR of type A in n minus k square log n time using linear space. Here, n minus k is number of convex vertexes, and since we check every pair of convex vertexes, we have to use n minus k square pair of convex vertices, and for each pair, we need to use ray-shooting query, so it takes log n time. Yeah. Okay. And from type B to E, we use some special data structure called staircase. Formal definition of staircase is following. For a point U in P, we define a staircase SU as the set of point P in P with x coordinates and y coordinates of P is less than or equal to x coordinates of U and y coordinates of U, such that the axis parallel rectangle with diagonal UP is contained in P, but no axis parallel rectangle with diagonal UQ is contained in P for any Q where point Q with which is left and bottom side of P. Intuitively, this is a maximal set of maximal points that can be then make the rectangle with diagonal UP is inside polygon P. I will show the picture later. And the staircase of point U in orientation zeta is defined as following. The staircase of U in orientation in the rotated coordinate system by zeta degree counterclockwise around the origin. Here is the staircase, picture of staircase. The blank line is a polygon boundary, and red line is staircase. Here, the eta U and delta U means the leftward and downward ray emanating from U, and eta bar, delta bar is foot of each rays. Then the staircase starting from eta U to delta U, eta bar U to delta bar U, and the staircase is XY monotone chain of line segment. So, and we construct and maintaining this staircase while rotating the coordinate system, then of course the combinatorial structure of this staircase changes, and we distinguish this all changes by event. Here is event of staircases. Each column means one type of event. First column is event that vertex V disappears from staircase, and second column is event that vertex V appears on staircase while rotating, and third column is an edge appears and disappears from on staircase. And these three events we call step event, and there's another event called ray event that is eta U or delta U meets vertex of P, then we call it a ray event. As you can see, at the ray event, there can be at most O(n) changes of segment. And note that the step event is continuous change, but ray event is not continuous change. And in each ray event, there can be at most O(n) change, and we call each change, each segment is made it by shift event. So there are at most O(n) shift events for a given ray event. So first, the step event. On one vertex or one edge can appear at most O(n) time, because once it disappears by some other point, then it can be appear again after this point get out of the staircase. So each vertex and edge can be appear at most O(n) time. This means there are at most n square step events while we maintaining S zeta U. And in the case of ray event, it is easy to show that there are O(n) ray events, because it is delta U meets vertex and eta U meets vertex. So, and each ray event can make O(n) shift events. So there are totally n square shift events while maintaining staircase. So we are following lemma: the number of total events that occurs on S zeta U during the rotation is O(n) square. So we compute all possible events in advance that there are k n square. Our algorithm computes a staircase of for every starting from every reflex vertex u. So there are k reflex vertex, and for each reflex vertex there can be n square events. So totally, we compute k n square events in advance. And we sort them and store it into event map. And so constructing this event map takes n k n square log n time because we sort them. Yeah. So we have following lemma. Once the event map is constructed, then the staircase for u can be maintained over all events during the rotation in n square log n time using n square space. The reason why is we have n square events and we can handle each event by log n time because using binary searching on event map. And we also construct the some candidate events called event queue, which can be at most all n square complexity. And this event queue ensures that the first element always happens, but we don't know the other events really occurs or not. But when the first event happens, we update this event queue. So we can every time we ensure the first element of queue occurs. This way, we are maintaining staircase. And as I said, we constructed for every reflex for staircase for every reflex vertex. So it takes k n square log n time and k n square space during the rotation for all staircases. Now I'll talk about how to find the LMR of type B2E. As I said, type B2E has at least one side contact on its side, and the side contact must be a reflex vertex. So we construct for each reflex vertex, we construct and maintaining two staircases. One is S zeta u and the other is S zeta plus pi over 2 u. Here, the red line is staircase and left side of u is S zeta u and right side of u is S zeta plus pi over 2 u. Then for each event in S zeta u and S zeta plus pi over 2 u, we find out DSG, which becomes infeasible after the orientation corresponding to events. What does it mean is that here is a polygon vertex, and after this angle zeta, this vertex appears to staircase, so that now it is impossible to make a rectangle with contact U, L, B, R. Now it is possible, but after this angle, because of this new vertexes, it is impossible to make rectangle with only using U, L, B, R. So we capture every this kind of event every time, and we found the DS U, L, B, R, and we compute the maximal configuration and breaking configuration of this set ULBR. This can be done in constant time because the area function has only here. We can find the maximal configuration and breaking configuration in constant time because the area function of rectangle satisfying Z is only one variable, the angle zeta. So there are constant number of extremal value, and we can get the maximal configuration from this extremal value. So it takes only constant time. And we have to feasibility check because after we finding some orientation, which is a maximal candidate of maximal configuration, and we don't know it is really lies inside P or not. So we have to check using ray shifting data structure. So it takes log n time. And so our algorithm computes all LMRs of type B2E in kn square log n time using kn square space. The time and space is a bottleneck because of the we making staircase and maintaining staircases. And last one is type F. Type F is like this. Three or four corner contacts on rectangle without side contacts. And first, for finding the LMRs of type F, we first compute all orientations such that the breaking configuration of type F occurs. Actually, this is there are n cubic such event, such orientations. So we capture all that n cubic such orientations, and for each orientation, we found the DS which have breaking configuration at that orientation, and found similarly found the maximal configuration and breaking configuration of that DS. Then we can find the LMRs of type F in n cubic log n time using linear space. Actually, in the case of convex polygon, convex polygon has every vertex is convex, so we don't have to consider the type B to E. So the only our concern is type A and type F. So if we want to find the maximum area rectangle in convex polygon, we just apply type A and type F, which complexity is time complexity is n cubic log n time and linear space, which is actually which can be improved to n cubic time, but I will skip the detail. So we have this conclusion. We can find the maximum area largest rectangle contained in a simple polygon with n vertices, possibly with holes, in n cubic log n time using k n square space, where k is reflex number of reflex vertices. And actually, I will explain the case of just simple polygon, not holes. But if there is holes, we can do very similar way with some little techniques. And so our conclusion is, it is also possible in the same time and space complexity. And it is shown that there can be omega and cubic combinatorially distinct rectangles, even P is convex polygon. So we wonder if our algorithm can be improved, because if the algorithm calculate every combinatorially distinct rectangle, then it needs at least n cubic time. So we wonder it. Thank you.
Is there a big difference between the simple rectangles and general rectangles?
Actually, left side is a general rectangle and right side is simple polygon. But we can divide general polygon into some simple polygons. So the reason why we use simple polygon is for our convenience. Yes. It can apply easily.